on page 202 in the front porch. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Creator and Redeemer, as you plan the wedding in Canaan in Galilee by the presence of your Son, so by his presence thou bring your joy to this wedding. Look in favor upon your guests. May at length celebrate with Christ the marriage feast, which has no end. Amen. time and time again. That's just the way that we are. But we know that somehow marriage and blending your two lives together has to do with love. And I think it is St. Paul who most clearly and articulately talks about what love is. That classic passage from 1 Corinthians 13. Love is patient and kind, not jealous or boastful. Those are very easy words to read. They sound very nice. And yet, we know that there are those times when we are not inclined to be very patient. There are times when we have been offended by our partner and we don't feel like being very kind to the partner at all. Sometimes we can become jealous. We can be boastful and put the other person down. Sometimes we can have our feelings hurt and become very, very arrogant, cut off the other person and be rude. And while he says love is not insisting on our own ways, I suspect all of us at one point or another are going to be extremely bullheaded in our relationship with one another. And we say, this is the way, it's the way we need. Our human inclination is always to follow what Paul has to say. And yet, Paul, when he wrote this passage, wrote it to a congregation where they were disagreeing with one another. They were not a happy, friendly lot. And he tried to say to them in very clear, straightforward language that for us as Christians, Jesus Christ becomes the model for us. And as he reflected love, love that was so deep that he was willing to give his life, that's the kind of love that we as Christians should show to one another within the community of faith, but especially in that relationship of husband and wife. Today you begin a life's journey together. Our prayer, the prayer of all who come and share in this service, that it will be a long and rich, joyful, and rewarding time. Let us bless God for all of the gifts in which we rejoice today. Lord God, constant in mercy, great in faithfulness with thy praise, we recall your acts of unfailing love for the human family, for the house of Israel, and for your people, the church. We bless you for the joy which your servants Michael and Marilyn have found in each other. Pray that you give to us such a sense of your constant love that we may employ all of our strength in a life of praise of you, whose work alone holds true and endures forever. Amen. Let us pray for Michael and Marilyn in their life together. Faithful Lord, source of love, pour down your grace upon Michael and Marilyn, that they may fulfill the vow.
napkins, Christy.
Yeah.
wedding.
It's hard taking pictures against those windows over there because you get a lot of light there. I don't know where else.
about Thomas dancing around a few times around the floor. You don't have to dance the whole number with us.